Also, a peach flavored Mega Man, peach colored Mega Man costume. Fucking awesome. But most of those items suck. Like, the only other one I can think of is Mega Man 5. You get peach color and you have Charge Man's charge kick, which basically turns the slide into a weapon. Which you think, okay, that's cool. But no, it's not cool, because every time you use it, if you don't kill the enemy that you were fucking fighting against, then you take damage every time you get it. Or even sometimes if you do kill him, you take damage from the attack. So it's like, it's almost like a kamikaze weapon. But even more so than like all these shield weapons, like Starman Shield and Woodman Shield, where you can actually kill an enemy without having to take damage. If you just like, you know, they hit the side of you, like close to you. Or, you know, even Woodman, you can just throw his shit at people, but no. Charge Kick, you gotta run right through him and hope that you don't get hit. But it's not as bad as Mega Man 3, where you get Tornado Man, not Tornado Man, Top Man's weapon. Top Man's weapon is you just spin around like a dumbass, and so you have to take damage every time you fucking attack. There's nothing really you can do about it. And then, like, you lose, like, all of the energy in, like, 2 spins, based on how much damage it takes to kill the enemy. It's like, you could be fighting the boss that you needed on, and just run out in one shot, and he's not even halfway dead yet. It's like, oh, well, I'm kind of fucked now. So, Flashman, yeah. Everyone's favorite public indecency boss. That's what they call him, Flashman. I don't know why this fucking level had to, like, have an icy ground. I don't know if you could tell, but whenever I stop moving, I'm sliding around because this is actually, like, slick and icy. I could fight you. You're in a vulnerable position. But fuck you. I slipped and fell. I'm gonna deal with the consequences. Now, yeah, okay, this is actually the guy who's weak against Metal Man and not weak against other weapons. So he takes like 4 hits. 3, 4, no. That was really tough. I don't know how I was able to climb over those insurmountable odds. It's fucking testament to the human spirit. I get the F weapon. Yeah. Oh, I get item 3. Item 3 is so stupid. It's completely useless, because, you're gonna see it in a second. Well, I don't even think I'm gonna use it in the next level, because I can get it to get some items, but I don't fucking need them, so I'm probably not even gonna use them. But it's just like a little wall climber. You're gonna see him use it in Wily stages. And, basically you use it only when, you only use it when it can be used and you don't want to use item weapon 1 instead, which is the little floating platforms, because otherwise it's completely fucking useless. You know? Unless you feel like playing hopscotch across the world or something, I don't know. But this is everyone's favorite Mega Man 2 level, because you can instantly die if you don't do these platforming sections right. Which is why they give you, you're supposed to kill Flashman first, which, coincidentally, Flashman's weapon is also this boss's weakness, but not in the way that you would think. If you have a full clip of Flashman's Time Stopper, then you can deal 50% of Quickman's life damage. So he'll be at half life when you run out and you have to fight him with the rest. And there's some other weapons that you're gonna see me use that do significant damage. Okay, now watch this. This is the fucking bullshit part. You're gonna do this just perfectly. I almost died. I probably should have died. Almost died again. Well, not really. Okay, this part's not so bad. Basically, after you get to those first 2 screens, if you can get to those first 2 screens without fucking up and dying, then you're golden. As long as you know exactly where you're going. Even that was kind of close. There, home free. That's like the hardest thing that has ever been put in any Mega Man game ever. And I just did it without fucking up. Kind of proud of myself for that. Which is why you're supposed to use the Time Stopper. Because chances are, you're not going to do it right on the first try, or on any try ever, and you're out of lives, and you're going to use up all your E-Tanks, and you're going to be fucking pissed at yourself. So use the Time Stopper right off the bat, and then the obnoxiously loud Death Beams don't fucking kill you. They just stop appearing until you run out of energy. Okay, now watch this. Stop him. And it doesn't fucking kill him. It just puts him at half life. Now I still have to deal with this fucking wily ass motherfucker. And his half life. Which thankfully, Air Blast does. It does an impressive amount of damage, so no problem. And he's easier to predict than Clash Man was. Because he bounces around like a dumbass. But then he just like runs into a wall for a second, so you can get him in that shot when he's against the wall, because he won't move. He'll just sit there until he's ready to jump again. Oh yeah. Pink Man is best Mega Man. And this is everyone's favorite sound effect of any Mega Man game, the fucking annoying ass, the cops are coming to shove a nightstick in your ass beeping sound. Oh, I hate the beeping sound. I don't know why they thought it was good. It's so not good. Level 1. Now, one of the things that, like, I fault Mega Man 2 for being inferior to Mega Man 3 for, this is the thing that kind of makes up for a lot of it, is this just this fucking theme music. It's the best Wily music, probably the best dungeon music ever made. It's so spectacular. You know, you can make like a million songs that sound just like this. Which, by the way, I don't know if anybody's ever noticed this, but anybody has an Iron Maiden, oh, this is item 3, by the way, completely useless unless you're up against a wall. And you don't want to, because I could have used item 1 and had the same result. But item 1 is a lot more versatile, so I'd rather not use it unless I need to. So, that's what item 3 is for. Just to be less useful than item 1. But anyway, I don't know if everybody else notices this, but, anyone listen to Iron Maiden, you ever notice that pretty much all of Mega Man music sounds like fucking 8-bit Iron Maiden? And I know Iron Maiden came before Mega Man, you know, but that's kind of what's kind of like, just totally, Japan was just hard up about Iron Maiden, which wouldn't surprise me, because, you know, everyone was hard up for Iron Maiden, and they made this game, and like, what are we gonna make the soundtrack like? Let's just do fucking 8-bit Iron Maiden, but kind of, you know, Japan has their own take on popular music, so it's a little bit different than Iron Maiden would be. But it's pretty much what you'd expect from Iron Maiden. It sounds just like it. Mega Man X, not as much, which you think would sound more like Iron Maiden, because they have a much bigger repertoire of sounds and effects in the SNES, but nah. It sounds more original, actually, than Mega Man does, but I like Mega Man better in a lot of ways. This is kind of the beauty of simplicity. See, I'm rocking the Quickman pink Mega Man suit. Where the fuck am I? I fucking disappeared from the screen. This is some fraps recording glitch bullshit. So I'm just gonna stand here and fucking wail him on his skull, and he's dead. Oh, that was so hard. It's the hardest fucking boss. Where's my face? My face is just gone. It's just, it's been sucked into the impenetrable void of darkness behind me. Level 2. I know one of these bosses is so fucking frustrating. Don't even know. There's another thing that this, like, I don't like about this game, is one of the bosses, you need to have a full clip of Clash Man's item, for one thing, otherwise, just start the whole level over, and, you know, not even, like, just the boss part, just start the whole level over, just go back to fucking level select screen, and start over, lose all your shit, because you can't beat the boss, it's impossible, and, not only do you have to have a full clip of Clash Man's thing, but you can fuck up. You have to do it in just a certain way where if you don't, or if you don't fuck it up, then you can kill him. But even then, you gotta use like all your platform items to fucking do it. And you see, I took that other route, the harder route with the E-Tank, even though I don't fucking need an E-Tank because I have 4 already. Just because I didn't want to have to deal with using Clashman's item and risk running out of Clashman's item before I get to the boss, which is not the boss of this stage, it's gonna be the boss of the next stage, I think. But still, I have to kind of prepare for that shit, because if I fuck it up now, then I'll never be able to do anything about it. So, though if I wanted to, I could just like sit here and grind these guys. You know? But, yeah, I'm not gonna do that. I don't need to grind anything. I'm good. Whatever. I don't even know. I don't know if you could use anything to kind of speed that shit up. Like, maybe, no, Metaman's effect doesn't work. So, I don't know what that was about. This fucking pisses me off. It's, one thing I got hit on that other thing, which is bullshit. Shouldn't have done it. I'm stupid. But how do you avoid this? It's fucking impossible. I've never been able to, like, the thing that you don't notice about this game is that Mega Man's kind of slippery. Like, if you ever play, like, Mario and Luigi on Mario Brothers, where Mario, like, he's slower and he can't jump as high, but when Luigi runs, he fucking slides across the room like he's wearing, like, ice skates or some shit. That's pretty much what Mega Man does in Mega Man 2. And it's not like that in any other Mega Mans. Maybe Mega Man 1, but he's kind of slippery when he doesn't stop all the way. Like, when, like he kind of has, Sonic the Hedgehog inertia problem or something. I'm gonna use this E-Tank, I'm probably gonna regret it. I'm probably not gonna get hit, but I don't wanna die and have to do the whole fucking level over again. I don't even need these E-Tanks anyway. There you go. Yay. I destroyed a room. Couldn't you just teleport it, like, all the way to the boss room if you wanted to? I mean, where are you going, you know? This is where it starts getting serious because the fucking level music changed. It's getting kind of creepier. Yeah, I weighed the options and I don't really need that item or those. Just gonna run through this real quick. Fuck it. Aw, giant fish! Oh wait, no, that's not a giant fish. Here's a giant fish. Where the fuck is a giant fish? I think Fraps caught the giant fish. So, this is another tricky part, because you can instantly die if you don't just fucking hold on a stick, but you don't want to hold on it too far, or you'll fucking die anyway. Unnecessary frustrating. Also that. I fucking hate these guys. There's nothing you could do when you see them. It's like not like you could slide and dodge. You know. Alright. So now I'm fighting the Guts Dozer? Is that what I'm fighting? Yeah. A whale in his head. I'm missing his head apparently. Look at this. Thanks for coming. Oh god, that was hard. The hardest shit. Which at least, like, they kind of changed it in other Mega Man games, or, like, the future ones, where you can't just sit there and wail on a guy. You have to, like, there's, like, a little buffer period, so, like, Mega Man has, where you get hit, and you're invincible for, like,